called Lemon thing because I grew up with it.
You grew up with that story being one
yeah,
word?
Yeah, but with a different version of it, not like a period.
Why do you think the version you heard is different from the one we put together?
Well, I mean the mosquitoes and the bees.
Okay, we got the mosquitoes and the bees and the mosquitoes from a written version, but it's different from the book that you had when you were little or the story your family told. Does anybody want to make a hypothesis? Why do we have a lot of different versions of the Paul Bunyan story? Andrew?
It was told by a bunch of people, and every time they told it, they maybe remembered it differently or decided to add something.
So 100 years ago or 150 years ago, somebody might have invented one version that got told to many people and ended up being the one that got written down that you saw. And 60 other people might have told different versions and they were written down in other places. It's got a name. Do you know the name of that? Where things change a little bit over a long time. And a lot of things that are very similar, but they're not exact. It's called the folk process. These are folk tales. They're not copyrighted, and middle schoolers know a lot about copyright because you have to be very careful when you're researching not to violate somebody's copyright and take exactly their words. You have to put them in your own words. But these stories, we don't have to ask permission to play. When the middle schoolers did their play, they bought a script because those words are owned exactly the way they're written down. You paid for those scripts so that you could tell that playwright's version of Mark Twain's story. We picked stories that are in the public domain, that we didn't have to ask permission.